Guys, you have heard of Greta Thunberg, right?
Who has? Greta Thunberg, we call her.
Wait, is this the young girl who's been saying all kinds of bullshit?
Yes, a climate activist.
Mm-hmm. Not bullshit, Bart.
This is what the other person told me. I don't even know what she's about, but other people tell me.
Climate activist.
Oh, okay.
It's depending on what you believe, it's bullshit or it's facts.
Listen.
Good point.
This chick understands what the fuck is going on, and she's willing to hold the United States feet to the fire while she completely ignores what China is doing.
Wait, what?
Iceman.
Thank you.
Isn't she like 9 or something?
She's 16 or 17 or 18 or 17.
Because she cried on camera and it was passionate, so people listened to her.
I'm just saying she seems to let China off the hook for quite a bit of the CO2 emissions that they do. That's all.
Oh.
There is this anti-Greta, coming about.
Uh-oh.
Her name is Naomi, and she's a 19-year-old German.
Oh, shit!
But she doesn't like to be referred to as anti-Greta, because she's like, I ain't got no beef with her. She's nice. Cool, okay. Or whatever.
I ain't got no schnitzel with her.
I don't got no schnitzel.
But the whole point here is...
I'm just trying to pretzel, you know?
I got no schnitzel, I'm just trying to pretzel.
Yeah. Why can't we pretzel and get together like this, like family, like the peace sign?
Naomi, she denounces climate alarmism, which she claims that Greta is a climate alarmist. And so instead, Naomi is saying that she is a climate realist and that she's all about the facts and that she believes that the current climate around climate is very exaggerated. And she just wants people to be like, hey, listen, chill out.
Nice, I like what you did there.
Who's panicking?
The world.
A lot of people are panicking.
Really?
People are panicking.
Really? Honestly, it's
I don't know, nobody.
Media outlets and mostly
college students.
Yeah. And then when you look at the polling,
Leonardo DiCaprio,
the bottom of the fucking list for most Americans because they don't really.
Yeah, because how are people like prepping? I feel like people have more earthquake kits at home than they have for climate change kits at home.
A lot of young kids right now, they're listening to Greta, and there's this like weekly event on Fridays that it's called Fridays for Future, where there's all these young people and they're just like, yeah, do something about the climate. We're about to, like, the world's gonna end in 12 years.
But what do they do?
But they don't even think that.
So this is Greta. This is Greta, right?
Is she cold?
Here she is at one of the like Fridays for Future events.
Is that global cooling? Is that why she's wearing a scarf?
This is Naomi. She's the anti-Greta we're talking
about. They're battling it out.
And so recently, well, she is a YouTuber, and recently the Heartland Institute.
Oh, the Stater Brothers Foundation.
California. They now have her on her team. On their team, sorry. Okay, this is what she said.
Oh, she looks Asian right there.
She does look Asian. I thought she was Asian, actually, when I first saw this, and then I saw the other photo.
Hey, did you know that white people have the Asian eye thingy, too?
What does that mean, like an epicanthal?
Yeah.
Well, and plus, she's doing a wing eyeliner, so making it look sharper.
She's got a little smoky eye a little bit. Yeah.
Here we go.
Hello, everyone. Hello. My name is Naomi Zeit, and I am a new member at the Heartland Institute. And I've got very good news for you. The world is not ending because of climate change. However, we are currently being force-fed a very dystopian agenda of climate alarmism that tells us that we, as humans, are destroying the planet, and that the young people especially have no future, that the animals are dying, that we are ruining nature. I truly believe that many members of Antifa, Fridays for Future groups, Rebellion Extinction, I really believe that many of them have good intentions, but that they are genuinely scared of the world ending. We at the Heartland Institute, we want to spread truth about the science behind climate realism, which is essentially the opposite of climate alarmism. Many people are now actually developing mental disorders and referring to them as eco-anxiety and eco-depression. And I believe it is important that we act now and change this entire mainstream narrative of fear-mongering and climate alarmism, because it's basically just holding us hostage in our own brains.
Wow.
Okay, now I'm convinced Europeans are just a lot more smarter than us. Well, at 19!
Greta's also European.
It's only because they say like, yes, less.
She's Swedish.
And we can't help it.
She says it 3/4 less than we do.
Oh, I didn't even hear one like in there.
I think I wanted to hear it, so I made one happen.
I don't even know what alarmism, that fraction is.
Alarmism was a word until right now.
And also, she's 19. And the whole time I'm thinking, you should be sounding like German, but you sound English.
Yeah, she does, right?
She's supposed to sound like, you know.
Let's hear it.
Would you like a prayer, sir?
Would you like a what?
Would you like a prayer, sir? Or a Wiener Schnitzel?
So is Greta Thunberg pretty pissed?
No, her people haven't even commented anything about
maybe
Naomi.
She's low hanging fruit. She's like, I'm here.
I'm way up here, bitch.
She's like, new school.
What are you gonna do? Yeah.
We're like, when rappers try and throw diss tracks at Jay-Z, and he's like, who cares?
Because Greta's like up here.
Yeah, Greta has won a Nobel Prize, I believe.
Zan.
Yes. Oh, no, she's a contender for the Nobel Peace Prize.
Well, that doesn't mean much. Honestly, they put a lot of people up for those.
She was, she has been, like, Time Magazine's, like, Person of the Year,
yes.
which is the youngest in history.
Oh.
I'm going to create something called the Nobel Disaster Prize, which is the opposite.
Yeah, me too.
They already have something like that, don't they?
I thought the guy that created the Nobel Prize.
The Razzies.
Is the one that, the Razzies, is the one that created the atom bomb. And I think because he created something so crazy, he felt bad and he wanted to create something positive.
Well, that's awesome, but I had no idea. Because I think it'll be good if we find a award system to award the people that's created negative in this world.
So opposite of Nobel Peace Prize.
Yeah, the Nobel Worst Prize.
Nobel War.
Tiff, do you know which country has reduced their CO2 emissions the most in the entire world?
America!
In the past year? Yeah, America.
America! So,
well, specifically, Tiff and I. Right. You guys had nothing to do with it.
Okay, but why did that happen? I don't think it was some fucking concerted effort or whatever. I think that it's because the people have been demanding things like ecological, like safe cars, like Teslas, all this stuff. I think the market's kind of taking care of a lot of this stuff for the rest of us.
Do you think it has been taken care of because of the yelling?
That's what I was gonna say.
I think that's part of it. Yeah, I think that's called market forces, right? People demanding something. Like the reason why we have organic food. Why do we have fucking Whole Foods and shit, right? It's because people are like, yo, I don't want to buy all this fucking
GMO shit. The produce here is bad.
Right. So the people stood up and said, I want this, and then they got it. And so I think that that's a huge reason why we've seen a reduction in CO2 emissions from America. But meanwhile, India, China, all these other cats, nobody fucking comes down on their asses.
Well, now they don't have cow dung coals in India. They're trying to do something.
It's great. It's great. But they do so much.
Isn't it funny that
burning of things in India that it doesn't, it's sort of moot, right? That they change one thing. Like, so, and what Joe's about to say is so smart.
Damn, you're a mind reader now, Steve?
No, because
he's a Joe reader.
Real quick.
My last point is this. If everything's so fucking urgent, and I believe in climate change. I believe that if CO2 really is heating the earth, we have to do something about it. The only thing to do about it is nuclear energy. Nobody fucking wants to do it. They all say it's fucking, oh no, you don't want to do nuclear. Nuclear is the solution if you actually want to turn back the clock and fix the problem of CO2 emissions.
Why is everyone afraid of it?
Because nuclear shit.
Because of Fukushima and stuff?
Chernobyl?
I think the name.
But frankly, they have
a bad branding.
Yeah. Honestly, everything's branding.
Frankly, it's so safe to do nuclear. There's been very few issues where we've actually had a problem. Even in San Diego, we had a nuclear problem. And they were able to flush it. And
the nipples are gone.
They're still there.
Oh. The nipples on the five?
But they're gonna tear them down. They're gonna tear them down. They're gonna tear the titties down.
Trust science. Science says nuclear is the way to fix it. That's the actual way to fix it. All this other shit is,
like,
to me, hype and a bunch of fucking, yeah, she's right. There's a bunch of hype around it if you're not talking about actual solutions.
I don't know enough to argue or agree with you.
What do you know about the Heartland Institute?
I don't care. They sound like a bunch of jokers, frankly.
What are they doing?
So they are described as a conservative think tank.
Okay.
And that they are known to feed into the climate denial.
Right, and climate denial is a whole other thing, right? Where you're just saying, I don't think that anything's happening. I don't think the earth is heating, all this shit, right?
Mm-hmm. That's actually what Naomi's
saying,
too.
Who are the people that are like...
I buy it.
Who are the people that believe that... global warming and cooling does happen, but it's a natural force of just Earth because we've had many ice ages and all that. And
I think that's the climate denial side.
Well, you can argue that, right? So, okay, so I've done my fair share of both sides of this. And that's why I think that what people are saying about CO2 heating the Earth is pretty legit.
Mm-hmm.
But scientists even can't confirm that that's actually what's happening, right? They don't know that CO2 for sure heats the earth. It is advanced theory. They have confirmed it in models and stuff. But so far, we don't know for absolute certainty that CO2 heats the Earth. And so that's where a lot of the fucking middle ground comes into play of like, hey, do we really know it's not sunspots? Do we really know it's not other fucking human activity that we're not even detecting, right? So this idea that you can just say, you just throw a whole bunch of people into a denial camp because they say a certain thing that makes kind of sense, right? Hey, there was a medieval warming period where we actually had more fucking CO2 in the atmosphere, and yet there.
How come they never wore shorts back then?
We didn't have as much CO2 in the atmosphere, and yet it was still warmer than now. Like, why? Like, stuff like that are pretty interesting arguments that people just cast aside and they go, that's a talking point. Or they go, that's just denialism. And I'm like, well, that's just a point they're making. Like, let's actually debate it.
Well, you can deny, right? Because it's a debate, it's a point of denial. So it's a position.
Exactly.
But I think all this shit is just too much for my brain. I just want to go back to horoscopes.
I'm a Virgo. Does that mean I'm helping to heat the Earth more?
You know what's it? You know what my
are you a fire sign? Because maybe.
Apparently I am. So maybe I am.
Can I tell you guys something sinister that I believe?
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks for asking.
You gotta do this first though.
Yeah. Tell me everything.
So I go, yes.
That's not very sinister. That's kind of cute, bro.
Okay, I go, yes.
Okay.
This is even more powerful, right? Yes, and we need to reduce the population. Why? Because yes, there's a lot
of
cars.
You're Thanos-ing right now. Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of cars, but think about it. We are the most populated we've ever been in this world. Humans generate heat. What happens there? Not only do we generate body heat, we use a lot of heat and electricity.
Wait, but what about his previous thing about there, like the medieval heating, and there was no CO2? Then there was less people then.
But they're not generating.
Well, what's going to happen to the ice, man?
A lot of people say, so just to be completely fair, a lot of people say that there was more volcanic activity around then. And so that's why. So I'm not even saying I know one thing or the other. I'm just saying that both sides have.
You're just pointing things out.
Some interesting arguments that shouldn't just be thrown into the waste bin and going, you're just a denier or you're just a climate change alarmist, like what she said. Like that shit's bullshit.
You have to science because how's she gonna be like, this is real science. You do fake science.
Right. Yeah, you know what's funny? Both Greta and Naomi are saying, we just want the truth to be spoken.
I like Greta. A lot of people don't like Greta. I like Greta because I know that, you know, I don't think that her tactics like of like the whole I'm gonna yell at you thing, I don't think it's effective.
How
always.
Dare you?
Right, the how dare you thing. Everyone always makes a meme out of that. But I like that she's sticking up for something that she really believes in. And she seems to have, I mean, people like to say that, oh, her parents are pushing this shit. I don't think her parents could push.
Yeah.
I don't think her parents could get that much info into this kid's head. Like, this kid believes this shit.
I think the real reason why she's doing this is so she doesn't have to go to school.
That would be really good. So that's fucking conspiracy corner.